Hello everyone, today we're taking a look at the Fagot IRC Worm. Now, before you come crying to me, this is actually the name given to this IRC Worm by both Kaspersky and F-Secure. So, this is not my doing. So, we'll go ahead and, before we take a look at it, we know the name is Daniel. We'll see that files will work normally as they are intended to. You can open Task Manager. Or maybe you can't, maybe you just can't do anything. There we go, regedit. We can open notepad. All these exe files work just fine. But as soon as we run Fagot, a lot of things change. So as we can see, we have quite a few errors going on here. So this error in memory block is a fake error message put out by the worm after it has finished its payload, which is to, as you can see from the file protection, destroy a bunch of files. Now it replaces a bunch of files on the system, and now anytime we try to open anything, it just changes the attribute to hidden and nothing happens. We view attributes of various things. Nothing works. It's all been replaced by the worm. A few files are missing. If we start, it hasn't changed the name yet, but one of the payloads on restart is supposed to change the username to Cock Sucking Fagot, which is where the name of the worm comes from. But as you can see, trying to open control panel windows cannot create a shortcut. Sure, shortcut to control panel, nothing happens, can't open anything. Windows can help you connect to a shared network folder and assign a drive letter to the connection. Trying to open my computer. So, as you can see, this computer is quite simply fucked. So let's go ahead and try to restart. Nothing at all happens. This computer is so badly destroyed. Shutdown does nothing. Can we turn it off? No. Alright, let's hard reset. So, as you can see, we cannot boot. We are missing ntoskernel.exe. And system's fucked. You'll need to reinstall. You probably lost a lot of your data based on this, and that's about it for the Fagot IRC worm. But wait, there's more. If we run the Fagot worm on Windows 95 or 98, like I did in my original video of this some 3-4 years ago, we see a completely different happening. So we'll try and run it. So we get the same error in memory block message, and everything appears to be as broken as it was before. So we look around, we see programs are gone. Refers to an object that has been removed or is inaccessible. Try to restart here. Machine hangs. Nothing's happening. Nothing is happening. Go ahead and, so as we can see, the worm itself is not responding. If we end that, we can restart. But unlike Windows XP, Windows 98 will actually boot into the operating system. So let's check out what happens. So, as we can see, our resolution has changed. And our font is now quite odd. I accept the agreement, I guess. I thought I already did this when I originally installed, you know, Windows 98. And ask you for your product key again. Luckily, I still have mine memorized. And next. So, we're good to go, apparently. Your display adapter is not configured properly to correct the problem. Select OK. OK, let's do it. Fix my... Oh, shit. Well, let's try to keep going. Crap. There we go. We're good to go. So it's gonna install new hardware for us. Alright. Let's scan for new hardware, I guess. We are detecting hardware. No more blue screens. We're doing alright now. See, progress bar is getting somewhere. I don't think that worm messed up the system too badly. Taking a while. What's it doing? What is it? Oh, it's still going. It's not frozen yet. We can not move the window very well. Oh, wait. I guess it's just lagging a lot. But we're still moving. We are moving along. We are getting there. We're about to find all our glorious hardware is good to go. Can I resize it? No. Virtual machine additions are gone. Come on. We're almost there. About to get our hardware going. Come on. Hurry up, please. All right, here we go. We're almost there. Yes, we have made it to the end. Windows has finished detecting hardware and is ready to install support for all detected devices. All right, let's see what it detected. Communications. Ooh, look at all this crap. Sound blaster, display stuff, system speaker, system timer, nice. We're fancy now. Finish. I don't think that box is supposed to flash like that. Where did it go? What is happening? What is this computer doing? Why is nothing happening? Finish. Damn you, finish. Okay. Control delete. Oh shit. I guess it just restarted on us. Yeah, let's not reboot. Hold on. F8, F8. Safe mode. Safe mode will save us, right? Oh, we got scan disk anyway. That's a good sign. Come on, safe mode. Alright. We got display settings. Can't adjust anything. Okay, we're good to go. At this time, display properties settings are limited to troubleshooting changes only. Okay. Yeah, let's continue. No, I don't want to restart. We've had bad problems with starting before. Windows is running in safe mode. Alright, let's go. Explorer has performed an illegal operation and will be shut down. Oh, shit. Hoorah! We are stuck on this. So, even though Windows is still able to boot. You know what? Let's try booting into safe mode with command prompt. Let's do it. What we got? So. What we got in here? Oh, we still got lots of files. Still got lots of files. That's a good sign. That is a good sign. Dell Fagot.exe. Well, I've done all I can do. Let's boot. Or let's just not do anything at all. Wait. Yeah, all right. Let's do it. Cancel. I don't want to fix it. All right, we're good to go. Yes, continue. No, don't restart. Shit. Damn. Fuck. And system is dead. So really at this point, you're just gonna have to reinstall Windows anyway. So whether you're running Windows 9X or Windows NT, you are simply dead. And that's about it for the Faggot IRC worm.